Hello boys, welcome back to the channel. Hope you're all having a fantastic day. And hope you're all having a great day. Whatever you are doing today, hope you're having a good day. Remember, if you are new around here, please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. It would go a very long way if you could do that. So yeah, you could smash a like on the stream and subscribe, that would be very much appreciated. And hope you're having a great day. And so tonight's stream is just going to be a nice, chilled out stream. Talk to you guys in the comments. Just have a nice, chilled out stream tonight. Not going to do anything like crazy tonight. So yeah, going to have a nice, chilled out stream tonight. If you want to ask me any questions about how my day's been, or if you want to ask me questions in general, you are more than welcome to do that. Hello, Tyler. Welcome in. Hope you're doing well. How are you today, Tyler? Hope you're having a good day, Tyler, and how's your day been? No choice of staying in the championship. Yeah, I don't know, Tyler, to be honest with United. It's a bit hit and miss, isn't it, at the moment, like you say. Yeah, it's looking like you guys may be in the championship again next season, but there's a long way to go yet, so who knows. Time could change, it could change in a matter of seconds and time, couldn't it? So who knows, Tyler, it's football, isn't it? Anything can happen in football, it's just football, isn't it? I thought at one point I was the same about my team. I was worried that Arsenal were going to get relegated, but they won't now because we're in a good spring of form at the moment. We're doing quite well in the Premier League at the moment. So, yeah, I wouldn't say to be negative about United. They'll get better. They're probably struggling. Obviously, for example, you've got a new manager now, aren't you? That's probably not helped the player system, obviously. Playing under a new manager. I don't think it's the manager's fault, Tyler. I think it's how the players perform for the manager. Because the reason I say that is, Tyler, is because it can depend on two things, Tyler. It can depend on one, if the players, obviously the players want to play. The main thing what can happen with players is if they get on with the manager, because some players don't get on with managers, do they? It depends if all the United players get on really well with the manager, because I've noticed very well, because like with Steelers, for example, I'm not using it for a joke, but a few years ago, Tyler, Steelers had a manager. Hello, Maddie, welcome in. Steelers had a manager called Paul Thompson, and it was 2018? I can't remember when it was, because it's been that long since COVID and stuff. Basically, the Steelers players were like falling out with the coach. And they didn't get on very well with the coach. So part of it could be, Tyler, that they don't get on with the coach. Maybe they don't get on with the manager. Maybe they just don't get on really well with the manager. Maybe they just think, I don't want to play under this manager because his system's not very good. Or maybe they just don't like playing under the manager's system. They all have different systems, Tyler, what they like to do and stuff. So it might not be the manager's fault. It might be the players are not playing at their best potential. Because you'll know if it, what's wrong with United United are not a bad team, but they need to try and start winning games, don't they? Obviously, you've had a couple of tough games, haven't you? Obviously, losing to Blackburn last Saturday, and obviously having a lot of changes at your club, aren't you? So that's not helped the cause, has it, really?
Thanks, Derek. Well, both managers will be reminding their players.
Thank you, Maddy. Hope you have a wonderful day as well, and I'll see you on Monday. Or if not, I don't see you then. I'll see you probably tomorrow or something, or whenever. Oh yeah, by the way, chat, I've decided, because with career mode it gets a bit complicated doing on stream, so I've decided to do career mode off stream now, just for a bit. I will give you updates on it each day and tell you how I'm doing as well. Yeah, so I've decided to do career mode, just to do them off stream because I feel less pressure. I've got a game on next Saturday against Coventry after the international break. Yeah, I know, that'll be a good game actually. Cobb are playing pretty well at the moment. United need to get a win, though. It's must-win for United, though, against Coventry. I think you'll struggle against Coventry, because Coventry are doing quite well under their manager at the moment. Coventry beat... who did Coventry beat last week? Oh, they beat Bristol, didn't they? Yeah, Coventry beat Bristol away last week, so Coventry will be on a quite good form in it. Simon Moore, yeah. Yeah. I know. What I mean is, though, Tyler, Coventry will be on a high, won't they? Because you guys have just lost to Blackburn, haven't you? And they've just beat Bristol City at home. So Coventry will be on a high, won't they? Because obviously they've just beaten Bristol City before the international break, and you lost away at Blackburn, didn't you? So Coventry will be on a high because they've just beaten Bristol City, won't they? And but it is at Bramall Lane, though. United usually play well at Bramall Lane. I think the Coventry game is at Bramall Lane, I think. I'll check after this. You're doing well with... He's doing well with Coventry. Yeah, they are. Coventry are a good team. I can't underestimate Coventry. I've been very surprised by Coventry this season at home, yeah. Yeah, I mean, Coventry have actually been very good this season from what I've seen of them so far. Coventry could. I know it's too early in the season to say this, Tyler, but I think if they keep playing like they are, I think they could be a contender for playoffs this season, Coventry. They really do. Coventry are not bad. I'd love to play Coventry, because that'd be a good game. I like playing all the new teams that come up. I've enjoyed playing against Brentford, because Brentford have given us a good challenge, and I think Brentford. I think it's like Brentford, when Brentford came up this season, everyone thought, oh, 18 from League One. Yeah, I know. What I mean is, like, ball's gone. If you look at all the teams, right, where they all are now, like from Premiership level all the way down to League Two, I think every team in every division is improving. Like, if you look at the Premier League, for example, let's just give the Premier League as an example. You've got three good teams that have come up. You've got, obviously, Watford, you've got Brentford, and you've got Norwich, right? Those three have all come up, yeah, right? I know Norwich are probably, out of the three of them, everyone will say Norwich are the most likely to get relegated out of the three that have come up. But saying that, obviously, I know you probably know that Norwich have sacked their manager, and obviously Villa have as well. But, yeah, I've heard some news on managers, by the way. I meant to tell you about this as well. I've heard today that Villa have signed Steven Gerrard as their new manager. So, see what Gerrard's like in the Premier League. Obviously, he used to play in the Premier League, Gerrard. He used to play for Liverpool, didn't he? So, it'd be a bit weird for him coaching Villa, obviously, when he didn't play for Villa. So, yeah. Yeah, they announced today, Villa have announced today that Steven Gerrard's their new manager. So, yeah, we'll see what he does at Villa. And then there's rumours going around today that Frank Lampard's going to be the next Norwich manager. So I think it's an interesting one. Man U are doing ridiculous. Yeah, I know Man U are not playing really well, aren't they? A lot of Man U fans are saying they want Ollie out, everyone said. All the Man U fans are saying they want Ollie Solskjaer to get sacked. And apparently there's rumours going around if Ollie gets sacked that Zidane's coming into the place, apparently. That's what I've heard anyway. There's rumours going around that Zidane's coming in to replace Ole. Yeah, I know. Ole's been awful. Yeah, saying that though, my dad was saying, Tyler, that he said since they got rid of Alex Ferguson, Man United don't look very good since Alex Ferguson left. They've been struggling. And I don't think they're as good as they usually on what they were. I don't think they're as good as they were though, Man U. When they used to have Alex Ferguson, look at Ronaldo. I know Ronaldo's been quiet for the last couple of games. Ronaldo, United spent a lot of money on Ronaldo and he's not really done much since he's come back to Old Trafford. So, yeah, Man United don't look like great at the moment. I think we've got a good chance against Man United. Man United have been awful defensively this season. Arsenal have gone, I think we've won like, we've gone 10 games unbeaten now. We've got a tough game on Saturday. We've got Liverpool away on Saturday, which ain't going to be an easy game. We both had mixed results last weekend, didn't we? Obviously, we beat Watford at home and Liverpool lost away to West Ham. So Liverpool will be out to beat us at Anfield. Yeah, both like I say, they lost to West Ham last weekend and we won at home to Watford. So yeah, Ronaldo is angry at Ole. Yeah, I know. I saw someone saying something about he was bossing all the players around, apparently, Ronaldo, from what I heard anyway. But yeah, he's not particularly pleased with Ole at the moment. So yeah, I'll be very surprised if Ole keeps his job, to be honest. He's had so many opportunities to keep his job, Ole. Fair enough, the players are playing for their manager's job, which is what they should be doing. That's what you should be. It's only like if Arteta's job was on the line. I bet Arsenal would play for Arteta, wouldn't they? That's what Man United doing. They're playing for Ole, because you know if they don't start getting results, Ole's going to get sacked, and then they're going to have to bring Zidane in, aren't they? They have to get a new manager, which I think is going to be Zidane. There's been rumours going that Brendan Rodgers is going to Man United, which is weird. Brendan Rodgers has had a lot of moves recently. He's had a lot of links with like Celtic and stuff as well. So I don't think Brendan Rodgers will leave Leicester. I'd be very shocked if Man U get Brendan Rodgers. Because the problem is though, if they get Brendan Rodgers, Man U, then Leicester are going to have to get a new manager, aren't they? But I don't think Rodgers will leave. I think Rodgers will stay at Leicester. And I think Zidane will come in for Ole. What? Rooney taking his job, man. Understand? At Derby. Oh, yeah, I heard about. Yeah, I know. A lot of Derby fans are not happy with Wayne Rooney at the moment. A lot of Derby fans saying they want Wayne Rooney gone. So, yeah, Derby aren't doing particularly great in the Championship, are they? So, yeah, I'll be very surprised if Rooney keeps his job, because they have been pretty poor defensively. Yeah, I'll be shocked if Rooney's still there in a couple of years at Derby, because Derby have been, like, defensively, Derby have been pretty poor. So, yeah, I'd be pretty surprised if he's still got his job soon. But we'll see what happens with Derby. Obviously, Derby have got the point deduction now, haven't they? So, certainly what Sheffield Wednesday had last season, they had a point deduction, and obviously they got relegated due to the point deduction, didn't they? So, yeah. Well, a lot of fans were saying that Derby should have been relegated last season because, obviously, they cheated. And a lot of fans were saying that Wickham should have been allowed to stay up and Derby should have gone down to League One, but obviously they didn't get the point deduction last season, so obviously Wickham got relegated. But like I say, whoever comes up from League One to the Championship, it's always a big ask coming into the Championship. The Championship is one of those leagues that it's very hard to call. And Pulisic has it. Oh, it's a penalty! And we had United have not had a point deduction now. United have not had one now, just Derby. Just Derby that's got a points deduction. Derby did something wrong. So Derby have got a points deduction. Yeah, United have not got one, it's just Derby. Derby's the one that's got the points deduction. United haven't got one, just Derby. My friend will be able to play. My friend's a Blaze fan, so yeah, they haven't got a point deduction. Wednesday have not got one, and United have not got one, but Derby have. But that's why Derby have got less points than everybody else in Championship, because they've got reduction. And I think they might have finished out in reduction, I think, now. I saw they had like 5 points. I think they've earned all their points back, I think. Or they might have taken the points off now. Simeone. They've got the points and from drawing games and stuff. So, yeah. They might have ended for Derby. Yeah, they're rock bottom of the league. Yeah, no. Derby are bottom of the table at the moment. Obviously, have the points deduction on. But I think their points deduction is nearly over now, I think. So there will be. I think Derby's point deduction is nearly at the end now. Derby's nearly finished their point deduction. And the yellow card
for that, Stuart. And he's going to have to be careful now. That was a silly challenge.
Derby will be back to normal soon when their point deduction is over. We, Hull City. Oh, fair enough. Yeah, Hull are. I'm surprised Hull are near the bottom because I expected Hull to be a mid table team. Footwork. Hull are a decent team. I thought Barnsley would be down there. Since Barnsley was sat their manager, they haven't played very well. So I expected Barnsley to be near the bottom. I didn't expect Hull to be near the bottom. I got you. I think out of the three that are in the bottom two, the ones that I expected to be in the bottom three, I expected Barnsley to be in the bottom half, because Barnsley have not been very good. I expected Derby to be down there anyway, because Derby have got points deduction. But I'd say out of the three that are at the bottom, I could... Yeah, I'm getting the joke. So I'd probably say out of the two that I expected to be near the bottom... was Derby and Barnsley. I didn't expect Hull to be down there. I thought Hull would be mid-table. I thought Hull would be like probably like 15th, something like that. But yeah, I didn't think Hull would be low down. I think Hull will bounce back. I think once they get a run together, they need to play some easy teams, don't they? They need to play teams that are on bad form. I always find if you play a team that's on bad form, you've got a better chance of winning it. I don't know who Hull have got after the international break. But I think the key is for the bottom three now, for Hull, Barnsley and Derby. They all need to start winning games. If they can get a couple of points and teams around them slip up, then they're in trouble. Look at Cardiff, for example. Cardiff are in danger at the moment of getting sucked into that bottom three, so Cardiff needs to start winning as well. Oh, have you heard? I apparently meant to tell you today, Tyler, that Neil Warnock's been sacked as Middlesbrough manager, and apparently Chris Wilder's going to replace him, apparently. Chris Wilder's going to be the new Middlesbrough boss, so that'd be a bit weird, being at Middlesbrough instead of Sheffield. Yeah, so apparently Wilder's replacing Neil Warnock at Middlesbrough. Neil Warnock's been sacked and Chris Wilder's going in. We had a point deduction last season. Did you? I don't remember United having a point deduction. I don't remember you having one last season. I know Thingy had one last season. I know Wednesday had one last season, but I didn't know United had one last season. I know Wednesday had one last season anyway. Wednesday got a point deduction last season. I don't remember United having a point deduction. I'll ask Alfie later or at some point. He had one in the Premier League. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that one. Yeah. It's been that long, Tyler, because obviously since all the lockdowns and COVID, I completely forgot. Possibility for Aubameyang. As I was saying, speaking of that, I just had my flu jab today, so my arm's a bit sore. I've literally, about an hour or so, or 2 hours ago, I went to go and have my flu jab. Me and my mum went to have a jab at the doctor and speak to the doctor, so yeah, so my arm's a bit sore. I just had a jab, the COVID jab, so my arm's a bit, not my COVID jab, my flu jab. Done this flu jab for COVID, so my arm's a bit, left arm's a bit sore. But I'm not complaining about it because it's going to be sore for a bit and then I'll just spring. Hopefully tomorrow it won't be too bad. I started a West Ham career mode off screen. I played three games so far. I've won one and lost two. So far, in the first three games, I lost 3-2 against Newcastle away. I lost 4-2 at home to Leicester, and I beat Crystal Palace 3-0. And then the next game is Southampton away. United 7-0 versus United 7 Coventry-0. I know.
Fantastic work Coventry, to thwart the danger.
Yeah, I don't think United will win 7-0 against Coventry, Tyler. I think it'll be a lot closer than 7-0. Can't see Coventry having a mare. I think Coventry will play well.
And Aubameyang
now. I think it'll be a tight game, though. I'm going to go with 2-1. I'm sorry to say this, Tyler, but I think because United are on awful form and Coventry are on good form, I think Coventry will win it 2-1. But I think it'll be really tight. I know that's not what you want to hear, Tyler, but Coventry are on good form, so I think Coventry... United should win it since they're at home, but Coventry are go 4-4 then. Yeah, it's going to be a good game. Whether it's 4-4, 2-1, whatever it be, it'll be a very good game. It'll not be a boring game. Because United and Coventry are both good teams, so I think that'll be a good game. Yeah. I don't think you'll win it, but I think it'll be tight. I think if you get a draw out of it, you've done well, but I think Coventry will win it, I think. Coventry seems to be playing pretty well under Mark Robins at the moment. United are struggling under their manager, aren't they? So, yeah, I think it'll be tough for United to beat Coventry. Coventry are a decent team. On their day, Coventry are very good on their day. And I'm not saying that disrespectfully. Coventry are a very good team. And I've always rated Coventry. They're a good team. I'm not saying I don't rate United, because I do. But Coventry are a very dangerous team. Yeah, I know. They're a dangerous team, Coventry. You can't underestimate Coventry. They're a good team. Coventry are a good team. I've always rated Coventry. They're a good team. You can't say Coventry are bad, to be honest. They're pretty decent. I think whatever happens this season is going to be very tight. Ah, so you got you. It's international break tonight, though. It's playing tonight here on the screen. Tonight it's Northern Ireland against Portugal tonight. And then on the screen, players to watch, it's Portugal. It's Ronaldo for Portugal and Callum Robertson for Northern Ireland. He's actually been very good for them, for Northern Ireland, Callum Robinson. It's a shame this game's not on TV, because if it was on TV, I might watch that tonight, Northern Ireland v Portugal. England are playing tomorrow night anyway. Yeah, England are playing tomorrow night. Yeah, England are playing Albania tomorrow night. I'm going to watch that. Be a good game. Yeah, it'll be a good game tomorrow night. I'm forward to that game. I expect that to be a good game tomorrow night. We should win that, but who knows with England. Should be a win, because we're at Wembley, and we always play well at Wembley for dinner. 3-0, yeah. I think we'll win tomorrow. That's what I predicted. Anyway, that's what I think as well, Tyler. I agree with you. I think it'll be 3-0. I think we'll win 3-0. I'm going to go with scorers-wise. I'm going to go with Kane to get one. Kane to get the first. I'm going to go with... I'm going to go Kane to get one, Sterling to get the second. And to get the third, I'm going to go with... I'm going to go Kane, Sterling... And let's just have a look who's in the England team so I can work out players wise. So I'm going to go Kane, Sterling. I'm going to go Kane to get one, Sterling to get one, and I'm going to go with Mount to get the other one. That's my scores. So I'm going Kane to get the first. I think Grealish. Yeah, I think Grealish will play well tomorrow. Yeah, so I'm going 3-0 England. And the goal scorers is going to be Harry Kane, Raheem Sterling and Mason Mount. They're my goal scorers. Kane to get the first. Kane to get the first one. Then Sterling to get the second. And then Mount to get the third. So I'm going 3-0 as well. I think we'll win 3-0 against Albania. And then against San Marino, which is the... Oh, yeah, Smith Rowe. Forgot about Smith Rowe. Yeah, Smith Rowe's been called up, hasn't he? We'll get one. Yeah, I'm going to see if Smith Rowe plays tomorrow night. I hope Smith Rowe gets a game tomorrow. Yeah, I forgot that Smith Rowe's been called up, hasn't he? Smith Rowe and Ramsdale have both been called up to England, haven't they? Isn't that good to see if Smith Rowe gets some game time for England tomorrow? I hope he does, because he's a good player, Smith Rowe. Can't wait to watch Smith Rowe tomorrow in an England shirt. Oof, can't wait to watch that. We've got Saka as well, don't forget. We've got three Arsenal players in the England team, haven't we? Because we've got Aaron Ramsdale, we've got Saka, and we've got Smith Rowe. So that's three players from my club in the England team, isn't it? Because we've got Saka as well, haven't we? And Saka's decent. I'm looking forward to see what... I wonder if he'll start Saka tomorrow. I reckon... This is what I reckon the team will go with tomorrow. Team-wise, I reckon he'll go Pickford in net, then defence, I think he'll go Kyle Walker, Stones, and I think he'll go Pickford, Walker, Stones, Maguire, Trippier, and then centre mids, I think he'll go with Rice and Mount as the centre mids, and then on the wing, I reckon he'll go Saka on the right, Grealish on the left, and then Kane up top. That's my team tomorrow. So I think the team tomorrow will be Pickford, Walker, Stones, Maguire, Trippier, Mount, Rice, Saka, Grealish, Kane. I think that's the team he'll go with tomorrow. I think he'll play Kane tomorrow. Ooh, why would you not play Harry Kane? I don't even know why. That's even a debatable question. He'll play Kane tomorrow. I swear he will. I bet you Southgate will play Kane tomorrow. He always does, Southgate. He never drops Harry Kane. I mean, we have got some good striker options there on the bench as well. So if you look at bench-wise, we've got Rashford, we've got Watkins, we've got... Who else have we got striker-wise? Let me have a look. We've got Rashford, we've got... As I say, we've got Rashford, we've got Watkins. Oh, we've got Bamford. Yeah, I forgot we've got Bamford. Let's just look at England team-wise, so for players that we can bring on as substitutes. Our team's pretty stacked, though. We've got Kane, Grealish, Saka, we've got Mount, Foden. Foden would be... I'd love to see Foden get some game time. Obviously, we've got Sancho, Rashford, Jaylings if he starts, Sterling, Calvin Phillips. I'd love to see Calvin Phillips play tomorrow. Declan Rice, Harry Maguire... Patrick Bamford, I love to see him come and get some game time. I think he'll go Pickford in net tomorrow. Other players to look out for, obviously Jude Bellingham, the young 19-year-old. They've got Trent, Sam Johnston, Tammy Abraham, I'd love to see him get some game time. Luke Shaw, Mason Greenwood, John Stones, Tyrone Mings, Ben Chilwell, Jordan Henderson, Aaron Ramsdale's been called up, don't forget. Kyle Walker, Smith Rowe, Trippier, Tomori, Ben White. Oh, Ben White's been called up. Blimey. Connor Cody, Reece James, Ward Prowse, Ollie Watkins, Dele Alli, Calvert Lewin, Oxley Chamberlain, Nick Pope, Danny Ings, Ross Barkley, Dean Henderson. James Maddison, Danny Rose, Callum Hudson-Odoi, Callum Wilson, Eric Dyer, Michael Keane, Jack Butland, James Tarkowski, Ben Godfrey and Tom Heaton. Pretty decent England team. Like, striker, so let's look at what strikers got. So striker-wise, we've got Kane, we've got Rashford, we've got Bamford, We've got striker-wise. We've got Watkins. To be honest, I think our team's pretty decent. We've got a good chance tomorrow against Albania. I think we'll beat Albania comfortably tomorrow. I might do a live reaction video before the match tomorrow night. Let's have a look what time kickoff is tomorrow night, actually. before we go any further, England national football team match. Let me have a look what time kickoff is tomorrow. 7:45 kickoff tomorrow. So kickoff's at 7:45 tomorrow. So I'll be live from, what time will I be live tomorrow then? A reaction video for the match. I'm gonna say they got, yeah, I know. Yeah, so out tomorrow for like reaction, I'll be live from about, I'll say I'll be live from 5:30. Maybe earlier, depending on what time I go live. Yeah, I'm aiming to go live probably about 5:30 tomorrow. So about 5:30 tomorrow. I'm doing like a reaction build-up towards the England-Albania game tomorrow. So I'll probably start that from about 5:30. So look out for that on the channel. Setting that up probably around 5:30. Yeah, I know. Yeah, tough. It'll be a tough game tomorrow. Albania, on their day, Albania are very dangerous. But I think these next two games are both winnable. I think Albania is a winnable game, and I think we'll beat San Marino. San Marino aren't great, so I think we'll beat both of them. To be honest, I think it was two wins on the bounce for England. I think we'll win both games. Can't see us losing any of the games. I think tomorrow night it'll be 3-0, and then next week, and then next Monday against San Marino, I think that'll be a win as well. That game I'm going to go 2-0, I'm going to go 2-0 for the San Marino game, and then tomorrow's game I'm going to go 3-0, but I think we'll win both games. What's your prediction for tonight's game then, Tyler? Northern Ireland against Portugal. I think Portugal will win tonight. I think Portugal are the favourite. Tonight's game, I'm going to go with 2-1 Portugal. I'm going to go to score for Ireland. I'm going to go Callum... No, not Callum. I'm going to say Callum Robertson to score for Ireland. And then for Portugal, I'm going to go Ronaldo to get one and Bernardo Silva to get the other one. I'm going to go with 2-1 Portugal. I think it'll be a tight game. I'm going to go 2-1 to Portugal. I think Ronaldo will get one for Portugal. I think they'll win 2-1 tonight against Northern Ireland. Right, boys, that is going to be it for today's stream. Hope you have enjoyed the stream. Remember, if you missed my GTA 5 stream this morning, that will also be up on the channel tonight along with this Ultimate Team stream. Don't forget, tomorrow I'll be live from 5:30 for the match build-up for the game between England and Albania. I'll be live for that tomorrow, 5:30, and we'll be having a Premier League discussion, for talking about every club, like one of the best players from each club in the Premier League. So then also we'll be having a Premier League build-up stream tomorrow as well on the stand. That'll be tomorrow morning, so listen out for that. So thank you guys for watching for now. Hope you have enjoyed the stream. Remember to like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys.